guys, welcome to the Science Hub. In this video, we are gonna discuss about the reproductive health. What is reproductive health? The complete well-being with respect to all aspects of reproduction like physical, emotional, behavioral, and social. A society with people having physically and functionally normal reproductive organs as well as normal interactions with respect to behavior and emotion among them is reproductively healthy. So, basically here we are gonna discuss about various problems that might be encountered while leading to good reproductive health and along with strategies that might be taken to prevent these problems. So, steps to achieve a good reproductive health. So here various steps should be taken. Government and non-governmental agencies should use media, both print and audio visual, to create awareness programs. Responsible adults, parents, teachers, close relatives and friends should provide correct information and be willing to open dialogues with young adults and children to sensitize them about good reproductive health. Introduction of sex education in schools and colleges. Create awareness about sexually transmitted disease or STDs. Educating people, especially fertile couples and marriageable individuals, about birth control options, pre and postnatal care, infant and child care, importance of breastfeeding, equal opportunities for males and females will help in bringing up socially conscious and healthy families of desired size. Create awareness about problems of population explosion, sex abuse, and sex-related crimes. Provision and availability of strong infrastructural facilities, professional expertise, and material support for successful implementation of health plans. These also help in providing medical facilities and care to people with reproduction related problems. Implementation of newer, better and upgraded facilities with respect to reproductive health. Complete ban on fetal sex determination to check female feticide. Large-scale child immunization programs for decreased maternal and infant mortality rates. There should be better awareness of sex-related matters, increase in medically assisted deliveries, and better postnatal care leads. So, we are going to discuss about population explosion and its causes, occur due to it, and various methods to control it. Population explosion, the rapid growth of population of a particular species, specifically of the humans in the world since the end of World War II. This can be attributed to a constantly increasing birth rate, a decrease in child and infant mortality, and an increase in life expectancy. This will lead to increased stress on all resources. So, causes that occur due to it. Rapidly declining death rate, rapidly declining maternal mortality rate, that is MMR, rapidly declining infant mortality rate, IMR, increased life expectancy, increase in number of people of reproducible age. So, various methods to control population explosion. First, promote smaller families. Then, promote use of contraceptive methods. Basically, contraceptive methods are various techniques that prevent pregnancy. Then, raise the legal age for marriage, that is 18 years for females and 21 years for males. Then, incentivize couples with smaller families. There are various methods that come under contraception. That is first, natural traditional methods, second, barrier methods, third, intrauterine devices, that is IUD. Fourth, oral contraceptives. Fifth, injectable and implants. And sixth, surgical methods. So here in natural methods, it work on the principle of avoiding chances of ovum and sperms meeting. First, in periodic abstinence is a method in which couple avoid or abstain coitus, that is sexual intercourse, from days 10 to 17 of the menstrual cycle when ovulation could be expected. B. Withdrawal or coitus interruption. In this method, male partner withdraws his penis from the vagina just before ejaculation to avoid insemination. C. Lactational amenorrhea. It causes due to intense lactation for about 6 months after parturition. No menstruation occurs during lactation period, hence chance of fertilization is absent. Physical contraceptive or barrier methods. This method prevents contact of sperm and ovum by barrier. Such methods are available for both male as well as female. This method prevents contact of sperm and ovum by barrier. Such methods available both for male and female. So basically is make barrier aega physical जो स्पर्म को ओवम से मिलने से रोकेगा. सो वन ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मेथड्स आर कॉन्डम्स. कॉन्डम आर बैरियर मेड ऑफ थिन रबर लेटेक्स शेथ. द मेल कॉन्डम इज यूज टू कवर द पेनिस. इट इज यूज जस्ट बिफोर कोइटस सो दैट सी मे नॉट एंटर इनटू द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ट्रैक्ट. इट ऑल्सो प्रिवेंट AIDS and STDs. The female condoms are diaphragm, cervical caps and walls made of rubber latex. These are inserted into the female reproductive tract to cover the cervix. As mentioned, condoms are one of the best methods as it protects from sexually transmitted infections including HIV, AIDS and unwanted pregnancies. B. Intrauterine devices, that is IUDs, are also one of among the contraceptive methods. These devices are only used by female doctor or by expert nurses. Insert these into the uterus through vagina. Different types of IUDs are, first, non-medicated IUDs. Example, Lipis loop acts as a barrier. Second, copper releasing IUDs, that is CUT, copper T, copper 7, multi-load 375. Copper ion release suppresses sperm motility and fertilizing capacity of sperm. It increases phagocytosis of sperm within the uterus. Third, hormone releasing IUDs. Progesterone, LNG make the uterus unsuitable for implantation on end, the cervix hostile to the sperm. Here you can see a T-shaped copper wire is placed inside the uterus. It acts as a barrier. It prevents sperm to meet the embryo or ovum. Chemical contraceptive methods. A. Oral contraceptives. This method is for female only. These are used in the form of tablets popularly called pills. It contains progestogens or progesterone estrogen combination. Basically ye ek tablet form mein aayega jisko hum pills bolte hain. Pills have to be taken daily for a period of 21 days started within first 5 days of menstruation. One of the example of these pills are Saheli, a non-steroidal preparation used as oral contraceptive pills. B. Injections or implants. Progesterone alone or in combination with estrogen used as injections or implants under the skin of female. It is very effective for long periods. C. Emergency contraceptives. These methods are used within 72 hours of coitus, casual in unprotected intercourse, administration of progestogens or progestogen-estrogen combination. Then, let's have an overview to surgical methods that are used as contraceptive. It is also called as sterilization method, advised to both male and female partner. Here, male and female both have different type of sterilization methods. A. Vasectomy. Sterilization surgery in male is called vasectomy. In vasectomy, a small part of the vas deferens is removed or tied up, as you can see in the photo. B. Tubectomy. Sterilization surgery in female is called tubectomy. In tubectomy, small part of the fallopian tube is removed or tied up. As you can see, there are three types of tying up the tube, that is first cutting, that is cauterized, second tied and cut, and third one is banded. Here you can have a brief overview about different contraceptive methods based on their effectiveness, and based on their effectiveness, it will lead to well birth control. And well birth control will lead to prevent population explosion. So, here are some contraception tips leading to well birth control. Consult your gynecologist to find the best contraceptive methods for you. Do not pop emergency contraceptive pills regularly. Oral contraceptives can have side effects if not taken properly. Copper tea is another method of emergency contraception. Condoms don't have side effects but have higher failure rate. Medical termination of pregnancy, MTP, also known as medical abortion leading to termination of fetus. Medical termination of pregnancy. Intentional or voluntary termination of pregnancy is called medical termination of pregnancy or induced abortion. MTP has significant role in decreasing population. Legal restriction is there only to reduce female feticide. This method is safe within first trimester. Here, sexually transmitted infections, that is STI or STD. Here you can have overview about various diseases that are transmitted through sexual intercourse. Diseases or infections which are transmitted through sexual intercourse are called STDs. These are also known as venereal disease, VD, or reproductive tract infections, RTI. Example, gonorrhea, syphilis, genital herpes, chlamydiasis, genital warts, trichomoniasis, hepatitis B or HIV. Except hepatitis B, genital herpes and HIV infections, others are curable because these are viral diseases. Here are some causes that common reasons for an STD recurrence. That is taking incorrect medication, forgetting to make sure your partner gets treated, being exposed to a new STD. So here are some symptoms, that is itching, flowing discharge, slight pain, swelling in the genital region. STDs remain asymptomatic in female and remain undetected for long. In the later stage, it may lead to pelvic inflammatory disease, that is PID, abortion, infertility, or even cancer in reproductive tract. Here you can have overview about symptoms that vary from males and between two females, leading to various type of STDs. So here are some points leading to prevention of STD or STI. Avoiding sex with unknown partners or multiple partners. Always using condoms during coitus. In case of doubt, consulting a doctor for early detection. Getting complete treatment for diagnosed disease. Infertility. It is becoming a big issue in today's era, as one have uneven diet plan, intaking of non-healthy food, and having in contact to radiation for longer period that affects fertility. This brings up the rate of infertility. The couple unable to produce children in spite of unprotected sex is called infertility. Problems of infertility may be in male or female. The reason of infertility may be physical, disease, drugs, immunological, or even psychological. Here are some methods for controlling infertility. That is, first, IVFET, that is in vitro fertilization, embryo transfer. Second, GIFT, that is gamete intrafallopian transfer. Third, ZIFT, zygote intrafallopian transfer. 4. IUI, intrauterine insemination. First, IVFET, in vitro fertilization embryo transfer. It is popularly known as test tube baby program. In this technique, ova from the wife or donor and sperm from the husband or donor collected. These are included to fertilization to form the zygote under laboratory conditions. The zygote or embryo, early embryos with up to 8 blastomeres could be transferred into the fallopian tube. Further development taken place within the female body. Second, GIFT, gamete intrafallopian transfer. It is the transfer of ovum collected from the donor into the fallopian tube of another female who cannot produce it. Third, ZIFT, zygote intrafallopian transfer. As with GIFT, your eggs are mixed with your partner's sperm in a dish in a lab and surgically placed in your fallopian tubes. But as with IVF, your doctor will wait until fertilization occurs to place your embryos inside of you. This procedure is no longer commonly performed because it has lower success rate than IVF. AI, artificial insemination, also known as IUI. It is the transfer of ovum collected from the donor into the fallopian tube of another female who cannot produce it. Thank you guys. For further update, please visit www.thesaihub.in.